Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll explain cross correlation for power signal. And to explain that, I'll explain this with these outlines where we will discuss basics of cross correlation for power signal. Then I'll define function of cross correlation for power signal. And at the end, we will see properties of cross correlation for power signal. We have already covered cross correlation for energy signal in my previous session. So you can see one. So both sessions are almost identical. Here only thing is we have power signal for which we do calculation of cross correlation. So that is only the difference. Otherwise things are same. Only very few things that you need to focus about. That is how to apply function for cross correlation in case of signals are power signal. So if we have two signals, x1 of t and x2 of t, and that is having same time period t, then I can define cross correlation for power signal. See, if we have two signals x1 of t and x2 of t with same time period capital T, then the cross correlation is defined as, first I'll explain you R12 of tau. So for cross correlation function for power signal, it has to be as per limit T tends to infinite 1 by t integration minus infinite to infinite x1 of t into x2 of t minus tau dt, where here we are correlating first signal with second signal, so we need to provide conjugate to x2. And similar calculation could be done by limit t tends to infinite 1 by t, it should be from limit from minus t by 2 to t by 2. We can shift x1 here, so x1 of t minus tau x2 of t dt, and here even we should place conjugate to x2 as we are calculating R12, means correlation of first signal with second signal. So when you calculate correlation of first with second, second signal should get conjugated. You can shift any of x1 and x2, but conjugate should be given to x2 in case of R12 calculation. And if you calculate R21, then it will be limit t tends to infinite 1 by t integration minus t by 2 to t by 2 x1 of t into x2 of t minus tau dt, where here we calculate correlation of second with first, so here conjugate should be given to x1 of t. And same thing that we can calculate by shifting x1, so that is limit t tends to infinite 1 by t integration from minus t by 2 to t by 2 x1 of t minus tau x2 of t dt. And here even you are shifting x1, but correlation is there of x2 signal with x1, so x1 that has to get conjugated here. So this is what we need to keep in our mind for power signal. This new thing is limit t tends to infinite 1 by t integration is from minus t by 2 to t by 2. For energy signal, we don't need any limits here, only integration with minus infinite to infinite is there. So this is what the difference in between correlation calculation for power signal. And for real signals, R12 of tau is equals to R21 of tau, as you don't have any conjugate of real signal, so both will be same. So if you have real signals, In that case, 4 x1 and x2 as real signals, we can say r12 of tau, that is limit t tends to infinity 1 by t minus t by 2 to t by 2 x1 of t into x2 of t minus tau dt. And here there is no need of any conjugate. Why? The reason is both are real. And same thing that we can have it for limit t tends to infinite 1 by t integration from minus t by 2 to t by 2. Here I'll be shifting x1 dt. So you can observe for r21 of tau, same formulas could be applied. So we can say this is what r21 of tau. So for real signals, r12 of tau is equals to r21 of tau. Now let us discuss properties of cross correlation for power signal. And those properties are so essential in calculation of examples. So I'll discuss properties now. So you'll be finding properties of cross correlation for power signal is almost identical to properties of cross correlation for energy signal. So first property, that even we have seen it for cross correlation of energy signal, that is it exhibits symmetry property. It exhibits conjugate symmetry property. So it exhibits conjugate symmetry. So if you have R12 of tau, and if you take conjugate of it, R12 of tau, then you will have to have minus of that. So it exhibits conjugate symmetry. If you take conjugate over here, and it will, if it is folded one, in that case it exhibits conjugate symmetry. So R12 of tau is equals to R12 of minus tau conjugate. And even you can have it for R21 of tau. So that is R21 of minus tau conjugate. So we can say it exhibits conjugate symmetry. Now see second property, that as I have told you, for cross correlation, it does not follow any commutative property. So it does not follow commutative property for complex signal. So it does not follow commutative property. It does not follows commutative property as it is followed in convolution. Here commutative property is not getting followed. Now see third property that explains if R12 of 0 is equals to 0 means x1t and x2t are orthogonal to each other. So if R12 of 0 is equals to 0, in that case we can say two signals x1t and x2t both should be orthogonal to each other. So this is third property. And same property that is there with cross correlation for energy signal, you can see my previous session where I have explained all those things. And last property, that is correlation theorem. So it states if you have cross correlation of first signal with second signal, and if you take Fourier transform of it, then it will be x1 of omega into conjugate of x2 of omega. And same thing you can apply it to R21 of tau, and if you apply Fourier transform, then that will be x1 of omega conjugate into x2 of omega. So this is correlation theorem, and this is even very important property which will be useful in solving examples. So these are the properties of cross correlation function for power signal. Same properties are there for cross correlation function for energy signal, and I have explained that even in previous session, you can see it. I hope that you have understood this session. Please do give your valuable suggestions. It is highly required to optimize my channel. So I'll consider all those suggestions which has been given by students. Thank you so much for watching this video.